Archaeologists have unearthed one of Melbourne's oldest buildings, harking back to the days when John Batman proclaimed, "This will be a village." Laura Turner says 50,000 artefacts they've uncovered tell the tale of a city that went from rags to riches.
While Melbourne's been a ghost town, the ghosts of our town have surfaced. The corner of King and Little Lonsdale Streets revealed to be one of our most significant historical sites.
You get into archaeology because these are the sort of sites that you hope to find.
These are the ruins of Mrs. Bruford's School for Young Ladies. An ad in the Port Phillip Gazette confirms the teacher's search for students, and today the fingerprints of an 1840s brickmaker still etched in the sandstone.
They're not on every brick, but they're on quite a few, and they're lovely little signatures of Melbourne at the time of its settlement and growth.
Archaeologists digging up 50,000 artefacts.
Extremely careful, extremely methodical, so it's a lot of work to get a site to this point by hand.
An old soda water bottle, a schoolgirl's name badge and an inkwell among them.
We know by the manufacture, the way that it's been designed, it dates to that period.
This is the tale of two cities in one. The schoolhouse, built pre-gold rush when Melbourne was struggling to survive. Just a few years later, and right next door, the grocery store, built to service the hundreds of thousands of people who'd rushed here because Melbourne had struck gold.
In the following decades, Melbourne flourished and buildings like Mrs. Bruford's were built over. Once this site is developed again, it'll be a 64-storey apartment building.
We would look at something that would integrate it, and for people to be able to reflect and know what was here in the past.
Laura Turner, Nine News.